You've heard about the importance of spaying or neutering your pets. Well, tonight there's one dog and 10 tiny ones just like her that are living proof of the dangers of not doing it. New at 6 tonight, News 4's Mike McCormick with the journey of an abandoned lab in labor.
Carolina Poodle Rescue is clearly just a name.
We take in about 75% or so poodles.
Acceptance is top dog here.
An animal in need's an animal in need.
They usually host about 150 wagging tails. On this day, the canine conversation is likely all about their newest four-legged friends.
Is that your baby?
Meet Tracy and her 10 kids. Their welcome to the world wasn't typical.
How can I say no?
On Monday, Carolina Poodle Rescue's director, Donna Ezel, was headed to the nearby Union County Animal Shelter to rescue this dog. On the way, the shelter's director called to tell Ezel about a chocolate lab.
They'd gotten the call to come and get her from the owners that they didn't want her anymore. And when they took her out of the truck, a puppy fell out. So the puppy made it.
Ezel loaded the lab and a few of her newborns into her truck and headed back to the poodle rescue.
And I spent the next 14 miles going, please don't have any more puppies, please don't have any more puppies.
The lab held off until they were back and she was safely in a sanitized empty kiddie pool.
Just a few minutes later, here came puppy number four. And about every 45 minutes for the next 6 hours, we had puppies.
10 of the 11 born survived.
We've had many dogs come in pregnant, like gonna go in a few days, but never that we're having the puppies on the way back. This was a first.
In about 7 weeks, they'll be ready for a new home.
No, honey, there's no milk in there.
For now, they're in good hands and in good company. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, Cherokee County.
Carolina Poodle Rescue is a no-kill shelter. The facility lives on donations. To help or to adopt Tracy or her puppies, look for the link in the Scene on 4 section of WIFF4.com.